Let us continue oxidation of alcohols. In the oxidation of alcohols, we are using oxidizing agent. What is the oxidizing agent we are using in the sense? CrO3 in glacial acetic acid values. So oxidant is what in the sense? CrO3 in glacial acetic acid. Glacial acetic acid. Okay, CrO3 in glacial acetic acid. This oxidizing agent we will use. Okay, so CrO3 in glacial acetic acid. We have to, it is the oxidizing agent. This will convert primary alcohol. This will oxidize primary alcohol into what in the sense? Aldehyde. Aldehyde is converted into carboxylic acid. So this primary alcohol is converting into aldehyde. This aldehyde on further oxidation gives what in the sense? Carboxylic acid. Okay. Next, secondary alcohol will take. Secondary alcohol is converting into what in the sense? Ketone. Secondary alcohol is converting into ketone. Tertiary alcohol. Tertiary alcohol, no reaction. Tertiary alcohol, no reaction. Then it is affecting double bond. This oxidizing agent affects a double bond, CC double bond. This not affecting double bond. This does not affect CC triple bond. But it is affecting CC double bond. It will break CC double bond. Okay. Sir, how the reaction will be there? CC double bond, CC triple bond is affected, we said. So how the reaction will be there? That we'll see. Now here double bond will take. Here triple bond will take. Then here OH is there. Like this will take. This compound will take. This is the oxidizing agent will take. CrO3 in glacial acetic acid is the oxidizing agent. Okay. It is converting primary alcohol into aldehyde into carboxylic acid. Therefore, this primary alcoholic group, okay, here this part, this is CH2OH. This CH2OH will convert into what in the sense? COOH. Sir. And does not affect CC triple bond. So CC triple bond is not affected. Okay. Then affects CC double bond. CC double bond is affected. Therefore, it is CC double bond. This CC double bond is breaking completely. Now, in the CC double bond, how it is there means in the CC double bond, if H is there, if this double bond will break completely, if H is there, it will convert into carboxylic acid. If double bonded carbon is having hydrogen, then that will convert into carboxylic acid. Now, this carbon is having hydrogen. This double bonded carbon is having hydrogen. Therefore, it is converting into carboxylic acid. It is CH3. Therefore, it is CH3. It is carboxylic acid. Therefore, what we will get means this will convert into acetic acid. Acetic acid. Then, this carbon will convert into carboxylic acid. This carbon also, this is a double bonded carbon. It is having hydrogen. Therefore, it is converting into carboxylic acid. Okay, that carboxylic acid will write. Then this CC triple bond will write. CC triple bond will write. Then this CH2 group will write. CH2 group. This CH2OH is converted into carboxylic acid, that will write. Okay. So CrO3 in glacial acetic acid, this oxidizing agent, if you take, this compound is converting into so and so. Next, we'll take next oxidizing agent. Next oxidizing agent is called what in the sense? Jones reagent. Next oxidizing reagent is called what in the sense? Jones reagent. This Jones reagent contains in the sense chromic acid. Chromic acid in the sense H2CrO4. This chromic acid in aqueous acetone solution. Aqueous acetone solution. Okay. So Jones reagent we are taking. Jones reagent in the sense chromic acid H2CrO4. Chromic acid in aqueous acetone solution. Okay. What it will do? It will convert primary alcohol into aldehyde. It will convert primary alcohol into aldehyde, we can say. It will convert secondary alcohol. It will convert secondary alcohol into ketone. It is converting secondary alcohol into ketone. Sir, tertiary alcohol is not affected here. Then It is not affecting CC double bond. CC double bond, no change. CC triple bond, no change. It is this oxidizing agent is not affecting CC double bond, not affecting CC triple bond. Okay, sir. So how the reaction will be there? Now one reaction will take. Okay, we have taken reactant like this. To this, what is added means Jones reagent is added. Jones reagent in the sense, what is that oxidizing agent? What is that oxidizing agent means chromic acid in aqueous acetone solution. So what compound we'll get? We'll see. This is a secondary alcohol, CHOH secondary alcohol. This secondary alcohol with the Jones reagent becomes what in the sense ketone. Secondary alcohol becomes ketone, we can say. This is secondary alcohol. The secondary alcohol becomes what in the sense ketone. Okay, secondary alcohol converts into ketone. Sir, next reactant will take. Next reactant will take cyclohexane. We have taken then CH2OH. We have taken. We will add Jones reagent into this. Okay, this CH2OH. It is primary alcohol. Primary alcohol is converting into aldehyde. Okay, so primary alcohol is converting into what in the sense aldehyde, we can say. So Jones reagent, this oxidizing agent converts primary alcohol into aldehyde, secondary alcohol into ketone. Set like this possible. Okay, we'll take next oxidizing agent. Next oxidizing agent is what in the sense MnO2 is a mild oxidant. MnO2 we can say mild oxidant. Okay, so this MnO2, how it is oxidizing, we'll say this MnO2 converts a primary allylic alcohol or primary benzylic alcohol. So primary allylic alcohol or primary benzylic alcohol is converting into aldehyde. So what is a primary allylic and what is primary benzylic, that we'll see. First, allylic means what? Allyl in the sense CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH2. This carbon is called allylic carbon. Allylic carbon means the carbon which is directly attached to double bonded carbon. That is called allylic carbon. The carbon which is directly attached to double bonded carbon is called allylic carbon. This is what in the sense allylic carbon, we can say. Allylic carbon. Now benzylic carbon, which is benzylic carbon? This is benzylic carbon. This is a benzylic carbon. Okay, so benzylic carbon is this. Now primary allylic alcohol, it is primary allylic alcohol. Secondary allylic alcohol is what? Secondary allylic alcohol is what? Okay, now this is a secondary allylic alcohol. It is secondary allylic alcohol. It is primary allylic alcohol. Now this is a benzylic carbon. It is a primary benzylic carbon. What is secondary benzylic carbon? That we'll see. Secondary benzylic carbon, that we'll see. Now this is a secondary benzylic carbon. So benzylic means what? Benzylic means the carbon which is directly attached to phenyl ring is called benzylic carbon. So this carbon is called primary benzylic carbon. It is called secondary benzylic carbon. Okay, so primary allylic alcohol or primary benzylic alcohol will convert into aldehyde with the oxidizing agent what in the sense MnO2. Then we'll take secondary allylic alcohol or secondary benzylic alcohol. We'll take secondary allylic or secondary benzylic alcohol. We'll take that we will convert into what in the sense that is converting into ketone. That is converting into ketone, we can say. Okay, so MnO2 mild oxidizing agent, secondary allylic alcohol or secondary benzylic alcohol with MnO2 oxidizing agent converting into what in the sense ketone. This oxidizing agent is not affecting CC double bond, is not affecting CC triple bond. Okay, so this oxidizing agent is not affecting CC double bond, CC triple bond. Okay, now we will take the reactant. Like this. Okay. Now we will add MnO2 oxidizing agent. MnO2 oxidizing agent is not affecting this CC double bond. Okay, it is affecting what in the sense? This is what in the sense? CH2OH. this CH2OH is converting into what in the sense aldehyde, we can say. So here what happens means aldehyde comes. This CH2OH is converting into aldehyde. So it is primary allylic alcohol. We can say this is what in the sense this is primary allylic alcohol. Okay, primary allylic alcohol. So primary allylic alcohol converting into aldehyde. So next we will take like this. It is a primary benzylic alcohol. It is primary benzylic. Primary benzylic alcohol will convert into what? Aldehyde. Therefore, CHO. Okay. Next we will take this compound. We'll take here OH, here pH, here OH. Like this, we have taken MnO2 oxidizing agent. We'll add. Now this MnO2 oxidizing agent will do what in the sense this secondary benzylic alcohol. Okay, this secondary benzylic alcohol is converting into what in the sense ketone. Secondary benzylic alcohol is converting into ketone. Therefore, this secondary benzylic alcohol is converting into ketone, whereas this alcohol is not allylic, is not benzylic. Therefore, it is not affected by this MnO2 oxidizing agent. Okay. So next reaction we'll take. Next reactant we'll take like this. Next reactant is here. Now in this case no reaction takes place. Why? Because this alcohol is not a allylic, not a benzylic. Which carbon is allylic carbon? Means this carbon is allylic carbon and this carbon is allylic carbon. Allylic carbon is not having OH group. Therefore, it is not allylic alcohol. This compound is alcohol, but it is not allylic alcohol. It is not benzylic alcohol. Therefore, with MnO2, no oxidation takes place. No reaction takes place, we can say. Okay. Next, oxidizing agent is what in the sense? Periodic acid. Periodic acid is doing what that we discussed already. In the place of periodic acid, what we can take in the sense, we can take lead tetraacetate is the oxidizing agent. Lead tetraacetate oxidizing agent we can use. Otherwise, we can use sodium bismuthate. Sodium bismuthate we can use. Sodium bismuthate, lead tetraacetate, HiO4, these and all behaving same with respect to oxidation. So these oxidizing agents behaving similarly, we said. Okay. Next we will see. So these are about oxidation reactions set. Oxidation reactions we discussed. So what are the oxidizing agents? We'll see again. Oxidizing agents. What are the oxidizing agents we have discussed so far? That we'll see again. We'll see. Now first oxidizing agent is what in the sense? Acidic medium or basic medium or neutral medium? Neutral medium. Potassium permanganate is the oxidizing agent we can take. Otherwise, acidified dichromate, acidified potassium dichromate we can take. Otherwise, dilute nitric acid we can take. Dilute nitric acid. These will convert what in the sense primary alcohol into aldehyde, aldehyde into carboxylic acid. Okay. Then secondary alcohol into ketone. Okay. Then tertiary alcohol into alkene. So, next. Same oxidizing agents we will use in drastic condition. Drastic condition if you use, what will happen? Under drastic condition, what is happening here? That we'll see. Primary alcohol is converting into aldehyde. Aldehyde is converting into carboxylic acid. Then secondary alcohol is converting into ketone. Ketone is undergoing further oxidation. In that further oxidation, ketone goes along with the smaller alkyl group. Therefore, two carboxylic acids you will get. Tertiary alcohol on oxidation gives alkene. In alkene, CC double bond breaks. Then you are getting a respective carboxylic acids you are getting. Okay. Then next oxidizing agent is what in the sense? Pyridinium chlorochromate, otherwise Collins reagent. Collins reagent. This oxidizing agent converting primary alcohol into aldehyde, secondary alcohol into ketone, tertiary alcohol, no reaction. It is not affecting CC double bond. It is not affecting CC triple bond. Okay. Next oxidizing agent is CrO3 in glacial acetic acid. Glacial acetic acid we can take. This is converting primary alcohol into aldehyde, aldehyde into carboxylic acid. Secondary alcohol is converted into ketone, tertiary alcohol not affected. It is affecting CC double bond, it is not affecting CC triple bond. Okay. Next oxidizing agent is a Jones reagent. This Jones reagent in the sense chromic acid H2CrO4 we have take in aqueous acetone solution we have take. Aqueous acetone solution. It is converting primary alcohol into aldehyde, secondary alcohol into ketone. It is not affecting CC double bond and CC triple bond. Next oxidizing agent is MnO2, mild oxidizing agent. It is converting primary allylic or primary benzylic alcohol into aldehyde and secondary allylic or secondary benzylic alcohol into ketone. It is not affecting CC double bond or CC triple bond. Next oxidizing agent is periodic acid or lead tetraacetate or sodium bismuthate. It is also oxidizing what in the sense vicinal diols or vicinal carbonyl group and alcohol. Okay. Next, we will go for next reaction. Next reaction is what in the sense dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation we'll see. We'll go for dehydrogenation we'll take. Okay. So dehydrogenation we'll take primary alcohol we'll take RCH2H primary alcohol we are taking. Here dehydrogenating agent is what in the sense copper at what temperature in the sense 573 Kelvin we are taking. Okay, we are taking 573 Kelvin. Sir, it is undergoing dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen. So here one hydrogen atom is removing as hydrogen H2. So what is the remaining means RCHO, aldehyde. So primary alcohol on dehydrogenation gives aldehyde we can say. Next we will take secondary alcohol. We will take secondary alcohol is RCHOHR. This secondary alcohol is heated with copper at 573 Kelvin. So what is happening means this hydrogen and this hydrogen will be removed as H2. So what we are getting in the sense we are getting ketone is a product. So we are getting ketone. Sorry, okay. Next we will take a tertiary alcohol. We will take tertiary alcohol. We are taking RCR. Okay, here. Here we will take a CH2R, this OH we will take. So here copper and 573 Kelvin is heated. So what happens, we will see. In this case, this bond is shifting here, this bond is shifting here. That means here dehydration takes place. Dehydration takes place. So we are getting a alkene we are getting. We are getting what compound in the sense alkene is the compound we are getting. Dehydration is possible but not dehydrogenation in this case. Okay. Next we'll see about opener oxidation. We'll see opener oxidation. This opener oxidation means what we have to do in the sense we are taking alcohol. In this case we are taking alcohol we are taking. Then we will add acetone into this. We will add acetone. We are adding acetone. Then we are keeping catalyst. What is a catalyst in the sense? Tertiary butoxide aluminium. Aluminium tertiary butoxide we are taking. So what is happening means this alcohol is converting into ketone. This alcohol is converting into ketone we can say. This acetone is converting into alcohol. This acetone is converting into alcohol in this process. Okay. So this acetone is converting into alcohol. This alcohol is converting into ketone in this case. It is not affecting olefinic bonds. Olefinic bonds is not affected by this oxidizing agent. So in this opener oxidation, this olefinic bond is not affected. This olefinic bond is not affected, we can say. Here some example we will say. In this opener oxidation, for opener oxidation, we are taking some example. Here OH group is there. Here pi bond will take. So now we have taken like this. So this opener oxidation in the sense, what is happening means this secondary alcohol, this is secondary alcohol, it is converting into ketone. Now this olefinic bond, this pi bond is not affected. Pi bond is not affected, we can say. So here double bond, here pi bond we will write as it is. Okay, so we will get so and so. Pi bond is not affected. Only what is affected means alcohol is converted into respective carbonyl compound. Secondary alcohol is giving what in the sense? Ketone we said. Okay, next we will see. We will take phenols. phenols undergoing electrophilic aromatic substitution, that reaction we'll see. Okay, phenols undergoing electrophilic aromatic substitution, those reactions we will take. Okay, now we'll take phenol. We'll take this phenol is undergoing electrophilic reaction, that means electrophilic substitution reaction. Now this OH group is whether it is ortho para director for electrophilic substitution or meta director for electrophilic substitution, that we have to see. Okay, now here we will see the resonance structure for this resonance structure. This OH group is acting as plus R group, therefore it is donating lone pair like this, pi bond is coming like this. So we will get this OH, this single bond becomes a double bond, then here negative charge will be there and these pi bonds will write oxygen will have positive charge. Next resonance structure we will see. In the next resonance structure, negative charge becomes pi bond, this pi bond becomes a negative charge. Okay, so here OH, here plus, here double bond. Then we can say here pi bond, we can say here negative charge, we can say. Okay, next we will see this negative charge becomes pi bond, this pi bond becomes a negative charge, we can say. Okay, so this OH we will give, this double bond. Okay, then we will give here pi bond will give, here pi bond will give, here negative charge will give. Okay, these are the resonance structures. So in the resonance structures, if you see, this ortho position is having negative charge, this para position is having negative charge, this ortho position is having negative charge, meta position is not having negative charge. Therefore, this OH group is making high electron density at ortho position and para position. Therefore, OH group is directing electrophile to attack at ortho and para position. Therefore, OH group is ortho-para director for electrophile, but meta director for nucleophile. Okay, sir, it is ortho-para director for electrophile. And this OH group is showing plus R effect. Therefore, it is activating phenyl ring towards electrophilic substitution. Sir, now we will see electrophilic substitution reactions. We'll see. Okay, we are seeing electrophilic substitution reactions. Now we'll take nitration. Nitration we'll take. We are taking phenol. This phenol we have taken. We are adding dilute nitric acid. Okay. Dilute nitric acid we are adding. On adding dilute nitric acid, what we are getting in the sense, orthonitrophenol we are getting. We are getting orthonitrophenol and then we are getting a paranitrophenol we are getting. Paranitrophenol. So we got orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol we got. These two we can, how to separate these two? These two we can separate by steam distillation. Why? Because this orthonitrophenol undergoes intramolecular hydrogen bonding, paranitrophenol undergoes intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Therefore, we can separate them by steam distillation because orthonitrophenol is steam volatile, paranitrophenol is steam, it is not steam volatile. Therefore, by pausing steam, we can separate orthonitrophenol from paranitrophenol, we can say. Sir, okay. Next, if you add corn nitric acid, what is the product we'll see? On adding corn nitric acid, so now we are taking phenol, we have taken phenol. To this, what we are adding in the sense, corn nitric acid we'll add. Phenol, corn nitric acid we added. So what is the product we are getting? That we'll see. Okay. So product in the sense, here NO2 group will be there, here NO2 group will be there, and here NO2 group will be there. Okay. So phenol is giving a picric acid. Picric acid it gives. Okay. So concentrated nitric acid, if you give, if you take 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, we are getting that picric acid we are getting. Dilute nitric acid, if you take a mononitration takes place. So dilute nitric acid, if you take mononitration, concentrated nitric acid means a trinitration is possible. Trinitration is possible, we say. Sir, what about benzene? That we'll see. Benzene on nitration. Benzene on nitration in the sense, what is a nitrating agent means corn nitric acid plus corn sulfuric acid. Corn nitric acid and corn sulfuric acid, if you take what product you are getting means nitrobenzene you are getting. See, for benzene, nitrating agent is concentrated nitric acid plus concentrated sulfuric acid. But for phenol, nitrating agent is dilute nitric acid. That means phenol is more reactive towards electrophilic substitution than benzene. Why phenol is more reactive towards electrophilic substitution? Because this phenyl ring is highly active towards electrophilic attack than this benzene ring. Why? Because this OH group, this hydroxy group is activating this phenyl ring towards electrophilic substitution. By what effect? By plus R effect. Due to plus R effect, this OH group making this electron density in the phenyl ring more than that of this benzene. Therefore, phenyl ring is highly active towards electrophilic substitution. Therefore, dilute nitric acid, if you take, nitration is possible. Whereas for benzene, we have to take corn nitric acid plus corn sulfuric acid we have to take. Okay, in the phenol, if we add corn nitric acid, what happens? Trinitration is possible. Trinitration is possible, we can see. Okay, next, this picric acid yield we will see. This picric acid yield is what, in the sense, very low yield of picric acid we are getting. What is the reason we are getting very low yield of picric acid? Means this corn nitric acid oxidizing this phenyl ring into parabenzoquinone. It is called what, in the sense, parabenzoquinone. This corn nitric acid oxidizes phenyl ring into parabenzoquinone. Therefore, yield of picric acid is very low, we can say. Yield of picric acid is very low. That means phenyl ring is highly active. That's why it happens like this. Okay. So, next reaction we'll see. We are taking phenol. To this, what we will add, in the sense, corn sulfuric acid we will add. Corn sulfuric acid. It goes for sulfonation. What is the electrophile, in the sense, SO3? So SO3 is attacking at ortho position and SO3 is attacking at a para position. So we will get a disulfonation, we will get. Then it is taken for corn nitric acid treatment. Corn nitric acid treatment. What happens means this sulfonic group gets a desulfonation, then we are getting what, in the sense, picric acid we are getting. Here NO2 group, picric acid we are getting. Here yield is high. Yield will be high now. Here yield will be high, but in the previous case, here yield will be very low. Why yield is very low here? Because corn nitric acid oxidizes this phenyl ring. Therefore, we are getting a parabenzoquinone. Why phenyl ring has gone for oxidation? Because phenyl ring is highly active. Why it is highly active? Because OH group is showing plus R effect. This OH group is activating the phenyl ring. That's why like this happened. Sir, what shall we do now? So first phenol we are taking for sulfonation. We got a disulfonic acid. This sulfonic acid, how it will be there? That we'll see. This sulfonic acid, SO3H, how it will be there? We'll see. SO3H, we can write like this. So this SO3H like this, in the sense, this double bond O, pi bond is shifting like this. So electron deficiency takes place at sulfur. Due to electron deficiency, this sulfur is acting as electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing group means it is deactivating the phenyl ring towards electrophilic substitution reaction. It is making the phenyl ring to have less electron density. Now, electron density at the phenyl ring is less because of electron withdrawing nature of sulfonic acid group. So that this phenyl ring goes for nitration in a smooth way with corn nitric acid instead of going for oxidation with the corn nitric acid. This phenyl ring is not going for oxidation with the corn nitric acid because electron density is low. This electron density is lowered by sulfonic acid group. Okay, so since electron density at this phenyl ring is low, it is going for nitration instead of oxidation. Therefore, picric acid yield will be very high, sir. Next reaction we'll see. We'll see about a halogenation reaction. We'll go for halogenation. We are taking phenol. This is treated with what, in the sense, bromine in chloroform. Otherwise, bromine in carbon disulfide. Okay, now here solvent is what, in the sense, solvent is having low polarity, dipole moment is very low, and low temperature is taken, how much, in the sense, 273 Kelvin we have taken. So here we are taking bromine, low polarity solvent, chloroform, otherwise carbon disulfide we are taking. And the temperature we are giving, how much, in the sense, low temperature we are giving. So what we will get in this case? In this case, what is the product obtained, in the sense, ortho-bromo-phenol we are getting? we are getting orthobromophenol and then parabromophenol we are getting. Parabromophenol, okay. So we are getting what in the sense orthobromophenol and parabromophenol we are getting. Sir. Now in the next case, in the next type of halogenation we'll see, we'll take phenol, we'll take, then we'll take brominating agent, what in the sense bromine in water we'll take, bromine in water, otherwise bromine in glacial acetic acid we'll take, bromine in glacial acetic acid, bromine in glacial acetic acid we are taking. And here solvent is what in the sense polar solvent. Polar solvent we have taken. In the previous case, solvent polarity is very low, temperature also very low. Sir, now what is a product we are getting here? Here we are getting a 246 tribromophenol we are getting. 246 tribromophenol. 246 tribromophenol we got. This is what in the sense white precipitate. Sir, now here why we have to take an, why we have to take low polarity solvent? Why we have to take low polarity solvent in the sense this bromine, bromine is should not be polarized to larger extent. So that only low polarity solvent we are taking. See that here high polarity solvent we have taken water. Due to that what happens, tribromination is possible. So if you want monobromination, what you have to take? Low polarity solvent we have take. Low polarity solvent is not polarizing bromine. High polarity solvent polarizing the bromine. Polarizing the bromine in the sense of Br plus easily available. Br plus easily available. But in the previous case, Br plus availability is less tendency. Br plus availability is less tendency. Therefore, monobromination is possible. But in this case, tribromination is possible. Sir, we said halogenation like this. Okay. Next, Kolbe's reaction we'll take. Next, we are taking Kolbe's reaction. In this Kolbe's reaction, what we are taking in the sense phenol we are taking, then we are taking sodium hydroxide we are taking, then it is treated with carbon dioxide at what temperature in the sense 390 to 410 Kelvin, 390 to 410 Kelvin temperature, then what is the pressure in the sense 6 atmospheric pressure, then treated with what in the sense HCl, treated with HCl, what we are getting in the sense salicylic acid we are getting. We are getting what in the sense salicylic acid we are getting. Okay, salicylic acid, it is orthoisomer. Orthoisomer is the major. Orthoisomer is the major. Suppose if we change the temperature, what is the temperature in the sense? If temperature is greater than 430 Kelvin, what we will get means paraisomer is the major. Paraisomer is the major. Sir, okay. So what is the chemical reaction? What is the mechanism involved in this process? What is the mechanism involved in this process? That point we'll see. So mechanism involved in the process we'll see. Now this OH group we'll take. This phenol we have taken. Sodium hydroxide contains OH minus. That OH minus we'll take. This OH minus is taking what in the sense? This H plus. This H plus and OH minus becomes water. This negative charge. This pi bond goes to oxygen as a lone pair. Therefore it is phenoxide we got. We are getting what in the sense? Phenoxide. So we got a phenoxide we got. Next, this phenoxide is treated with what in the sense carbon dioxide gas. It is treated with a carbon dioxide gas. Carbon dioxide we'll write like this. Okay, now what happens means a lone pair becomes pi bond. This pi bond becomes a negative charge. This negative charge attacking carbon. This pi bond becomes a negative charge. Sir, so we are getting a, so we are getting here a O double bond phenyl ring. O double bond phenyl ring, here pi bonds we will give like this, pi bonds we have given, here what is there means H C double bond O, O minus, like this we have treated, okay. Next, next point what happens, that we will see, next step we will see, next step what happens means this pi bond, this sigma bond becomes pi bond, this bond is going here, therefore we will get this OH, this pi bonds will be like this, here COO minus, COO minus. This is treated with a dilute HCl. This O minus takes H plus from HCl and gives what in the sense? Salicylic acid and gives salicylic acid. So what is the electrophile here? CO2 is the electrophile. In the CO2 electrophile, which is the electrophilic center? This carbon is the electrophilic center. Which is the nucleophile? This phenoxide is the nucleophile. Okay. So like this we are getting, if temperature is greater than 430 Kelvin, what is major means para product is a major, we can say. Okay, this is about a coal based reaction. In coal based reaction, carbon dioxide is acting as a weak electrolyte. Carbon dioxide is acting as weak electrolyte, we can say. Okay, next reaction we'll see, Reimer-Tiemann reaction. In the Reimer-Tiemann reaction, we will use phenol, we will use chloroform, we will use potassium hydroxide, we will use, what is the product we are getting, in the sense salicyl aldehyde product we are getting, sir. We'll see next reaction. Next reaction, we are taking phenol. To this, we will add zinc dust. It is solid zinc dust we are adding, and it is heated up. So what we are getting in the sense, benzene, we are getting a zinc takes oxygen. Zinc takes this oxygen and becomes what in the sense, zinc oxide. Okay. Next, phenol. Phenol we are taking, chromic acid we are taking. Phenol is treated with what in the sense, chromic acid. So what we are getting in the sense, parabenzoquinone. We are getting a parabenzoquinone. Parabenzoquinone we are getting. Then phenol we will take. This phenol is exposed for what in the sense, air and light. What happens means it undergoes slow oxidation. To give mixture of products. In the mixture of products, quinones is present. Some other compounds also present. It is appearing what in the sense, a dark color. So when phenol is exposed to air and light, it undergoes slow oxidation and becomes a dark color substance. The dark color substance contains mixture of products. In that one is what in the sense, quinone is one. Okay. Next we will take this phenol. We are taking phenol. It is treated with what in the sense, HNO2, nitrous acid. How to take HNO2 in the sense, mix NaNO2 and dilute HCl. Keep temperature how much in the sense, 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. Now what happens? What is the reaction takes place? That we will see. What happens to the HNO2? That we'll see. HNO2 we can write like this. And dilute HCl is giving H plus. That H plus we have written. So what happens means this oxygen is a donating lone pair to this H plus. Therefore we are getting a here water, here positive charge. Here what is there means NO is there. Next what happens means this pond is shifting. Water is leaving. So we are getting what in the sense NO plus. NO plus is electrophile. NO plus is what in the sense electrophile. This electrophile is attacking which position? This electrophile is attacking para position of this phenol. Therefore, it is attacking para position of the phenol. Okay. So now we will take so and so. Now NO plus is attacking. Therefore, we are getting what in the sense? Para nitroso phenol we are getting. Okay. So we got what product in the sense, para nitroso phenol we are getting. This para nitroso phenol is undergoing what process in the sense, tautomerism. It undergoes tautomerism. Tautomerism means position of hydrogen will be different. Tautomerism in the sense position of hydrogen will become different. That is called tautomerism. So the tautomerism symbolic representation will give, this bond shifting here, hydrogen comes to this place. Okay, so O double bond, this phenyl ring, here 5-1-5-1, here double bond, here N single bond OH, like this we will get. Okay, so this is, what is the name of this one? In the sense, monoxime of quinone, this we are getting due to tautomerism. Okay, so due to tautomerism we are getting like this, sir. So para nitrosophenol on tautomerism gives what in the sense, monoxime of quinone. Okay, now we will add a sulfuric acid. We'll see. This para nitrosophenol is in a tautomeric form. In tautomeric form, how it is there in the sense, like this present. This compound we'll take. we are taking this compound. This compound you have taken. We are already having phenol. We are having and a concentrated sulfuric acid. We will add. We added what in the sense concentrated sulfuric acid. We added. So what is the reaction takes place means water will be removed now. Water molecule is removed because concentrated sulfuric acid is the dehydrating agent. Therefore, it removes water. Okay, so water is removed like this. Water is removed. So what we are getting now? We are getting a so and so. We got a so and so. We got so and so product. We got sorry. Next, this is this with acidic medium. In concentrated sulfuric acid, H plus is available. Therefore, this O is taking this H plus. This O is taking H plus. Here, dative bond is possible. Therefore, we can write OH. And for oxygen, we are giving positive charge. Therefore, we can give like this. We can get like this. Here, this O minus. This O minus also. This OH will write. This OH. In order to satisfy this positive charge, negative anion is there. HSO4 minus. Okay. This is called what in the sense? Iodophenol of hydrogen sulfate or bisulfate, we can say. HSO4 is called hydrogen sulfate, we can say. What is the color of this one in the sense? This is green color, we can say. Iodophenol of hydrogen sulfate, it is what color in the sense? Green color. Okay. Next, it is treated with what in the sense? Water. This is treated with water. What happens means this bisulfate goes away. Water takes out this H plus. Therefore, we are getting what we will see. It is treated with water in the sense. It is treated with water. Therefore, now we are getting a O11. Sulfuric acid is removed from this. Therefore, we are getting a so-and-so compound we are getting. This compound is color is what in the sense red color. This compound color is red. This is indophenol. This compound is called what in the sense indophenol we can say. This indophenol is treated with what in the sense sodium hydroxide. This alcoholic group. This phenolic alcoholic group. This phenolic group is converting into what in the sense phenoxide. Sodium salt. Sodium salt of indophenol. It is what in the sense? Sodium salt. Sodium salt of indophenol we are getting. This is what in the sense? Blue color. Okay. It is blue color. So, therefore, phenol with nitrous acid. What is the reaction means like this taking place in this not only nitrosation also treating with the con sulfuric acid and then with the sodium hydroxide. Okay, so how this reaction takes place we'll see. First we are treating phenol with the dilute nitrous acid. Dilute nitrous acid is giving nitrosonium ion. Nitrosonium ion is the electrophile. It is NO plus. Nitrosonium ion is attacking at para position. So para nitrosophenol we got. This one tautomerism gives monooxime of quinone we are getting. This quinone is reacting with the phenol with the, in the presence of con sulfuric acid. Con sulfuric acid removes